You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Chu. At around 8 o'clock yesterday morning, Xinzhuang's Yufeng Temple held an illegal pilgrimage. Pilgrimage team members scuffled with police sent to the scene, resulting in the police firing 12 warning shots and using pepper spray.
Members of a temple team that had been setting off firecrackers on the street weren't happy to see police arrive on the scene. As the situation quickly started spiraling out of control, police fired 12 shots into the air. Around 8 p.m. on the 4th, New Taipei's Yufeng Temple started a pilgrimage. The temple did not get permission first. The pilgrimage team, which numbered around 150, set off firecrackers at the intersection of Xingzhi First Road and Fuhui Road. When police arrived, two members of the team refused to stop what they were doing and a scuffle ensued. The two men were taken into custody while the other temple team members left the scene after the police used pepper spray on the crowd.
状况为几之下，对空鸣枪12枪示警，以压制现场的气焰，随即将近30名快打警力到场支援。
The two men, surnamed Cai and Xie, respectively, were charged with obstructing officers in the discharge of their duties. The temple, meanwhile, will be fined by the fire department for holding a pilgrimage and setting off firecrackers without permission, which are social order maintenance violations.
A man surnamed Zhang fell victim to a fake job ad on Facebook and was imprisoned for several days at a Zhanghua guest house by a fraud ring during which he was forced to apply for bank cards. A bank employee notified the police after discovering suspicious transactions with Zhang's account.
Police officers surround the vehicle. Three men inside the car are members of a fraud ring.
有没有皮带啊？有没有皮带刀啊？
皮带也拿起来。皮带先给他绑掉了。哦，要捅我是不是？One worked as a driver for the fraud ring, and the other two were members of the ring. The man inside the bank, surnamed Zhang, was a victim. On November 21st, the Zhanghua County Police received a call from a bank employee alerting them that Zhang and two other men had arrived at the bank to apply for a bank card. The employee discovered suspicious transactions with Zhang's bank account and that it was being used by a fraud ring.
受到诈骗集团的监控下，要到银行办理提领款。他的账户里面哦，有大量异常的金流出入，非常可疑。Zhang
told the police that he answered a job ad on Facebook on November 16th. He met up with the fraud ring members in New Taipei City and was detained. They took away his phone and ID card and took him to a Zhanghua guest house where he was imprisoned for several days.
辗转在几间的民宿跟旅馆哦，受到控制。 但尚未受到凌虐或殴打。The
police confiscated $9 million NT in illegal profits that the suspects were preparing to remit overseas, and the two fraud ring members were arrested on suspicion of fraud, obstruction of freedom, and violations of the Money Laundering Control Act. The police will now determine the source of the funds and if there were other accomplices. They will also step up inspections of hotel and guesthouse operators to ensure they won't be used by fraud rings as places to imprison victims.
President Tsai Ing-wen called senior government officials to a meeting yesterday and ordered an evaluation of all senior government posts when the current legislative session ends. On the following day, the executive yuan announced that Interior Minister Xu Guoyong had resigned for health reasons.
Interior Minister Xu Guoyong, who was scheduled to attend a legislative interpellation on the 5th, has resigned. His deputy, Hua Jingchun, attended the interpellation in his place.
这涉及到长官去留的问题，并不是我们下属方便回答的问题。大家知道，部长长期都有气喘和脊椎的一些问题。上礼拜五，我看到他确实整个气色、整个状况不是太好。According
to an executive yuan statement, Xu resigned due to health reasons, and Premier Su Jinshan tried to change his mind, but to no avail. President Tsai Ing-wen convened a meeting of senior government officials on the 4th and ordered an evaluation of all senior government posts after the current legislative session ends.
政务官来去随缘啊，我想说每一个政务官都会把握当下，做好
该做的事情，以我个人而言，我想在这个工作的每一天都应该是尽心尽力，也跟同仁们来做后续相关事务的一些规划跟推动，配合整个那个改组的这个作业来办理。政务官本来就是没有任期，而且本来就是要对市政的所有的成果来负责，依照借调的这个启程会来办理。
Many want to know what will be the fate of Health and Welfare Minister Xie Ruiyuan.
你自己还会想要留任吗？部长，你有想要留任吗？
How great of a cabinet reshuffle will there be? Only time will tell.
Taipei City Mayor-elect Jiang Wan-an visited with Taipei City Mayor Ko Wen-je today to discuss the transition and handover of 24 major projects. Ko reminded Jiang to exercise fiscal discipline.
On the 5th, Jiang Wan-an and his campaign staff visited with Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je to discuss the transition. Ke says the handover will follow a project management format and includes 24 major projects, including Taipei Dome. Ke also reminded Jiang of the importance of fiscal discipline.
那这8年来，我们大概还了570亿的劳健保争议款，那内部基金大概减债100亿，欠债是要还的，第二欠债是要缴利息的。我算一算，我们去年的利息降到4亿多了，不过今年因为美国那个升息，你知道，财政局给我报告，有可能单单今年的利息就会超过9亿。
Zhang has appointed lawmaker Lin Yihua as the convener of his transition team. Observers say possible candidates for Zhang's mini cabinet include former Taipei City Deputy Mayor Ou Jingde, former Kaohsiung City Deputy Mayor Lin Sichuan, and former KMT City Councilor Wang Hao.
甚至要等久一点，好，再覆盖先，饭才会香。Zhang
also said he sees Ke as an important advisor and mentor, and hopes Ke will attend the New Year's Eve countdown with him.
希望柯市长能够与我在跨年晚会上与市民共同倒数，见证台北挺过疫情，还有迎接新的年度的时刻。我跟你讲哦，我每年跨年晚会不是在家里读书，都在家里睡觉。要不是当市长，特别就不会来，要不是偶尔才来参加，偶尔来参加。
It looks like Jiang will be counting down without Ke at his side this New Year's Eve.
Jiayi County Magistrate Wong Zhangliang of the DPP was re-elected in the recent 9-1 elections. Prior to the elections, he had formed a pan-green team with the aim of boosting the chances of local DPP candidates, and the strategy didn't work, with the DPP losing key elections.
This campaign ad featured Jiayi County Magistrate Wong Zhangliang and Pan Green candidates for township and city leadership positions. They expressed their determination to be elected together as a team. Wong was re-elected after receiving 70,000 more votes than KMT candidate Wang Yuming. However, the proportion of invalid ballots in the election was much higher than the national average. A total of 284,490 ballots were cast, and nearly 4%, or 11,196 ballots, were invalid.
通过选票所呈现出来的一个现象，我们谢谢大家对我们的鼓励，我们会继续努力。
The national average was only 2.5%, which was much lower than Jiayi's 4%. Wong said this situation is worth considering. The Pan-Green team's performance in the elections was disappointing. For example, the Pan-Green candidates in Taibao City, Puzi City, Mingxiong Township, considered to be the DPP's stronghold in the county, and Yizhu Township, Wong's hometown, all lost.
有可能就是说对政治上有一些比较反感的人，会觉得说他不喜欢两个政党，会想要去盖一个章，但是不想要让自己影响到选举结果。Scholars
say many ballots may have been cast in anger over dissatisfaction with the two major political parties. Wong said people expressed their feelings through ballots, and his team will take the results to heart.
And now some international news of the day. The historic eruption of Hawaii's Mauna Loa continued Sunday as lava flowing from the volcano edged closer to the Big Island's main highway. Supporters of COVID protesters in China marched in Toronto this past weekend demanding freedom in China and President Xi Jinping's departure from power. Foreign leaders of many countries have paid visits to Chinese embassies to express condolences on the passing of former Chinese leader Jiang Zemin, who died of leukemia and multiple organ failure in Shanghai. The Taoyuan city government spent $2 million NT dollars on its reusable cup scheme, but convenience stores say only 10% of customers are willing to use the cups.
According to official statistics, Taiwan uses and discards 4 billion disposable cups a year. Most consumers are not willing to use reusable cups due to hygiene concerns. Last year, Taoyuan became the first special municipality to pass autonomous carbon reduction laws. It also allocated $2 million NT dollars to a reusable cup borrowing program. According to statistics, however, only 10% of consumers are willing to use reusable cups.
那今年也擴大辦理，新增了中壢區的6個商圈的飲料店業者，共計有40家的一個業者。那我們的使用人數也破萬人數了。在密集的商圈、密集的夜市，它就不會覺得麻煩，我逛好夜市剛好把飲料喝完就還。所以說，你在一些可行的地方，你就不要讓民眾有選擇使用免洗杯的一個選項。
Taiwan Watch says wider availability and not giving consumers the choice of disposable cups are the keys to success. The Department of Environmental Protection says 40 beverage stores in the Liuhe shopping area have signed on to the scheme, and the cups are being cleaned by a professional cleaning company. It hopes the initiative will prompt more consumers to bring their own cups.
Thank you for watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. We'll see you tomorrow.